It's funny enough, today I'm actually going to do something rather productive. The day before Easter, talking about science. That's absolutely wonderful to the Catholic and Judaism religion. Beautiful, right? Yeah. Don't make videos a lot, but doesn't really matter. Point is, if you read the title, this kind of a documentation of what I believe, really not really believe, I don't like saying believe, but what I think, I can infer what time is and how could we control this. Time, to put simply, is the passage of space moving forward, if that makes sense. Okay, so the universe is expanding from, say, this point to this point, but they're not moving away from each other. They're just relatively moving away from each other. They're not actually moving. We're not actually moving at that speed. Of course, we could be if there was a force that was making us do that, but no, we are not actually moving away, all right? There's just more space in between these two points, all right? So even though my fingers are moving, just imagine the universe as putting two objects in a bathtub and then putting water in it. The more water you put in, the more they're going to spread apart. And if you had a big enough bathtub, they'd never hit each other because they're always constantly flowing away from each other at some arbitrary speed that for some reason our universe is picking up. It is speeding up, you know? I have no idea why. Maya, you want to sit in here with me? Discuss science. Beautiful dog that I have. Absolutely wonderful. Anyway, as what I know, that's as of what I know about space-time. But what is the fourth dimension? All right, I've been working a lot with this recently. Not that I have any mathematics to prove anything or any claims that I say, but I have a pretty good, I think I have a pretty good understanding of what it may be, all right? So, Einstein said that time flows through a fourth dimension, all right, another dimension. See, we have our regular X, Y, and Z, you know, planes. But what exactly is a dimension? Well, a dimension is space. And what is space? Space is anything that matter can go through. If there is nothing, if there is the even the lack of space itself, then there that means nothing. It is absolute nothing. When we discuss nothing in the universe, we don't actually mean nothing. There are small little quantum fluctuations that happen within our universe constantly. Particles that come into existence and then out of existence happen all the time. That's what we refer to as nothing. But this term that I'm coining right now, and I'm sure it already exists, is absolute nothing, where space doesn't even exist. And if space can't exist, then how could these particles even interact with each other? They don't have a medium to be in. The thing with space is that it is no medium, but it really is. Because if you can compare it to nothing at all, literally nothing, then space itself is a medium, all right? Dimensions itself is a medium. All right, so let's discuss dimensions. What is a dimension? What's the smallest point of a dimension? Well, it's exactly what that word is, a point. A point, or a zero-dimensional space, is just that, an infinitely small point with no up, no down, and literally, absolutely, nearly nothing. It isn't exactly nothing. It is nearly nothing. It is almost unfathomable. Actually, no, it is unfathomable. Our brains cannot comprehend the size of whatever this tiny little object may be. But if you put that out on a grid and stretched it all the way out into infinity, you'd get what we call as the first dimension. You're putting an infinitesimal amount of this infinitesimally small object across an infinite amount of nothing. Well, there you go. You got the first dimension. So how do you make the second dimension? Well, first, let's talk about the first dimension. If the first dimension is made out of particles, or let's just call it, I don't really know what to call it, just particles. All right, particles of space. If these particles of space have basically no up, no down, nothing, then how could they form this giant grid? Well, that's the thing. Think of it like pixels. You can't have a computer screen without pixels, right? And you can't do work when you only have one line of pixels, so you need to have two. Okay, well, two, you need to maybe stack one on top of each other. Well, there you go. But you need a lot more of that, right? And these pixels are really tiny. You really want to see the big picture. So that's kind of what the universe does. It allows space to exist in three dimensions. The first dimension is made out of these tiny little particles, but they stretch across so much that it basically, now it's just a line. But how do you make the second dimension, though? Well, all you have to do is very simple. You have to stack these lines on top of each other. So I got this line, and then I stack it on top of it, and then I stack and stack and stack. That's actually how area works, and that's also how volume works. If you don't know, or remember 10th grade geometry, any rectangular prism's volume is equal to its base multiplied by its height. Because if you think about it, if you find the area of the base and then you multiply the increments of space that it's going up at, then that's the height. And you just multiply the new numbers and you get the volume of the object or the rectangular prism or whatever it may be. Depending on the object, it will be completely different with different ratios, and it gets even more confusing when you add circles into it, because now you need to have pi, and you need to find the area of a circle, which is pi r squared, and then multiply it by the height of the cylinder. But if you wanted to do cones, and, you know, you have to multiply it by 1/3, and blah blah blah, there's a whole bunch of stuff. If you haven't learned it yet, don't worry, it's not that confusing, but, you know, it's up there. Anyway, the main point is that the second dimension is just a stacking of Earth dimensions. And you probably know where I'm going with this, but the third dimension is just a stacking of second dimensions behind each other. So now I have a line, and now I'm making it go up and down. But now I'm bringing it closer and farther away. That creates three-dimensional space. But let me show you something what means that we live in a fourth-dimensional space, that we live... Well, we don't live in fourth-dimensional space, we just transcend through fourth-dimensional space. We're not exactly in the fourth dimension. We cannot travel through it, we just transcend through. It's kind of like the fourth dimension seeps into our own, it's kind of weird. Take this pencil. That's not a pencil. Take this pencil. I can't break that. Shit. Alright, well, you know, probably shouldn't have cursed. That's okay, whatever, it's documented, who cares. I bet you in 100 years that word's not even going to be existent. Point is, I have my hand right here, alright? It's three-dimensional, you could see it, I have five fingers, I think I do, alright? Five, alright? And I could turn it, and I could bring it closer and farther. This is a third-dimensional thing. And imagine if I froze it in time. Now it is purely a three-dimensional object. Now, of course, I'm moving because... I cannot keep my arm still. Maybe if I rest it on something. Even then, it's a bit weird. But this right here, three-dimensional. Once I start moving it, fourth-dimensional. The reason why is because if we agree that the fourth dimension is temporal and spatial, though, remember, it is also spatial. It is not just temporal, it is spatial. If we subscribe to the idea that... the fourth dimension is temporal and spatial at the same time, then that means that the only way for my hand to move, and even anything to move by that motion, is through time. Time is the passage of space moving forward. So, think about this. Think about I had a first dimensional line, and I wanted to stretch that line. I can't. I cannot move the line. The reason why is because there is no time for me to do that. Literally, there is no thing in that universe that tells me that time actually exists. So I can't do it. I can't even move in this universe. So you have to add fourth dimensional space. A temporal and spatial field that somehow, and I know it sounds complicated and probably some weird sci-fi shit that might as well be wrong because, seriously, I don't even know what a temporal field is, a time field, alright? If these things exist, alright? You need to add a temporal field. You already have a spatial dimension, so you need to add a temporal dimension, and then you can actually move these. All right, so you have your little guy right here in the middle, and your whole universe is this big, and you're the guy in the middle, and you can't even move. You don't even think. Nothing happened, but you're just there. All right, once I add a temporal dimension, now you're like, oh, I can think now. I can move these. I can move them like this. And then if you have it with two-dimensional space, then you could do this, and you could, change the lengths of a y-axis and an x-axis. And then if you were in three-dimensional space, like we are, we can move, forward and back, left and right, towards and back, we could move through three-dimensional space. But why? How? That doesn't make any sense. I mean, we don't live in the fourth dimension. So what's going on here? This might be a product of possibly an error within our coding. Now, I'm not going to be one to say I believe, all right? Like I said in the beginning of the video, I don't agree with saying the words I believe. But I strongly agree, not completely, but I strongly agree that our universe is probably a simulation. Probably. And if that's the case, if so, and if I'm wrong, so what? It's a theory. A theory is a theory. If I'm wrong, then we got a lot of work to do. And we already do got a lot of work to do, but saying that our universe is a simulation is a very easy way of getting out of work. But if that's the way it is, then that's the way it is. It seems very possible. Why is the circle's ratio, right, to its circumference and its diameter exactly 3.14159 goes on as a transcendental number? All right? Why? Why is it like that? Why is the square root of 2 the ratio between the side and the diagonal of any square? Our universe must be a simulation. Some beings of higher power counted. They already thought of decimals, probably. All right? They probably just write it differently. But decimals exist because decimals exist in our universe. They have to. All right? God did not possibly, I don't know, but if by the laws of science, God probably didn't make up numbers. All right? He didn't pick 3.14159 as being exactly the ratio between circles and the diameter. It's very likely that the universe is a simulation. And if so, they coded for us to exist. Now, maybe not me. I might just be a model. They probably have, if I am a simulation in this whole universe, right? I probably am just merely a model to them that moves freely through space. But here's a little bit of a difference. We often recognize a simulation other than a reality. What if they were actually so intelligent that they actually were able to make an entirely different reality, a universe? Now, that's different from a simulation because a simulation doesn't exist. This does. Our world exists within another dimension, another reality. All right? If you guys ever seen Rick and Morty, it's kind of like that one episode where they go inside the little mini-verse in the little car battery. The concept's the same. It's not a simulation. It's just space that seems to be shrunken down to such a small level where time could be fit in there, and time acts completely different. I don't know how what technology you would be able to do that with, or how would you be able to do that, but I'm sure that it's possible. So there is a difference here. So it's either one where a simulation made of electrons, which means that there is a constant possible error within the universe. They might have messed up, which means I am actually a model. But if we exist within an actual spatial and temporal field, which actually exists within another reality, then I am real. I'm just on a really small scale. And I mean really small scale. Compared to them, my time would be completely different, and the entire laws of the universe would be completely different. So they devised a universe where these things exist. Maybe their universe is coded. Who knows? Who is the first universe? Why are we here? These questions are very hard to answer. And honestly, I think it goes for all the simple questions. If there's a simple question, there's not going to be a simple way to answer it, right? There just isn't. Especially when it comes to science and philosophy. So that is basically what space-time is, all right? And I hope that I can enlighten you, and if it's wrong, then I hope that I learn and I develop something new. As I get older, I hope that I be able to develop all the ideas that I have, because if I do, it will forever change the world. Trust me. There's a world out there that is waiting. Just to keep on going, all right? Keep it zesty.